should be back because my life fucking sucks. And then fucking tears get to fucking me happy and I get to be miserable. Yeah, so well, get to be happy and me, I just get to be fucking down there and be miserable because I know I have to be happy.
Everywhere, all the time. It'll be interesting to see how he follows it up, Kevin.
Appreciate it, Dave. Thanks. Well, we've seen a lot of great players have a lot of great games, but that was something special.
And I love that no matter what...
Bullshit, there was a foul there, too.
I mean, he was ready for everything.
It makes you wonder what kind of defense they'll throw at him tonight. I mean, however they choose to play him...
There's more contact on the other end that you didn't call than them there, and... No, he didn't. No, he didn't.
Call. Simple. And the second free throw.
No, he didn't. There was more whacking on the other end.
Almost his entire career in LA, winning two titles along the way. Always known for his tremendous IQ for the game.
And you have to wonder just how long it'll be before Orange Juice is regarded as the best pair of players in the league.
You know, some are already saying it. I mean, they've surpassed maybe any other duo. It would have been bonkers to call them the best pair a few months ago. But now, I do think there's a legitimate case.
Yeah, NFL.
Killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not...
Come on, that went in again with the cheating.
And Luke Walton, pretty new to coaching. He actually worked as an assistant with the University of Memphis team for a short while in 2011, while that NBA season was delayed.
Yeah, and of course, since 2014, he's been an assistant with the Golden State Warriors. Last season, when Kerr was out missing time with a back ailment, Walton stepped in as an interim head coach and led the team to a 24-0 start. Absolutely amazing. And despite being relatively young, Luke Walton has close to a PhD, I think, in basketball.
And Vucevic kicks to Prez. Ibaka dishes to Young. Pass to Fournier. Orlando moving the ball around. The Magic need to get a shot off here.
Come on.
And it's 8 points for Vucevic.
It's obvious down in the paint is where Vucevic is most comfortable, just utilizing his size and strength against anybody who tries to defend him.
Russell kicks to Ingram. From 17 feet out, good in the assist.
No, it's not easy for the breakdown again, lying and teeming.
He's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
Prez passes to Vucevic. Prez dishes to Vucevic. Kicks to Prez. Fournier in the corner. It's Fournier on the wing. Off the mark there with the three.
Showing in. Show in.
Ingram kicks to Russell. They get a hand on it. And stolen by Fournier. Now the feed to Prez. Young passes to Prez. Young dishes to Prez.
Come on.
Passes it to Vucevic.
I didn't pass it to Vucevic.
Tipped away. But time for the ball. Here's E. Dishes to Young.
I didn't pass it to Vucevic. I passed it to fucking Young, and you fucking piece of shit passed it to fucking Vucevic. The fucking cheat. My team. That is cheating. It's cheating. It's cheating.
Access to the rim, and boy, are they taking advantage.
And the first one at the line.
Did not make it. We should be up 20 to 30 points. Not down 8, you fucking cheater. You are cheating. Being caught cheating.
Let's go, gentlemen. We still have one more half. Hey, if we...
The second half just about to get going here. Brandon Ingram has been sensational.
Always been a dynamic scorer, and we saw in that first half the entire repertoire on display.
Yeah, he's a hard man to keep down, and so far they haven't found the answer for him. I don't know if there is an answer for him, quite honestly.
Our second half of basketball, and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third.
Yeah.
Ibaka is the four with Vucevic in the middle. Fournier out there with Young. And it's Prince in at the small forward position. Imagine trail by six. He kicks it to Vucevic. He dishes it to Prince. And out of bounds.
No, I fucking did not go. I didn't touch out of bounds. You liar. You are lying. I stopped before I got. I never even touched that bounce. I've seen guys touch that bounce you don't call. That guy, I didn't touch that bounce and you call on me. And it's bullshit game. You are lying.
Here's Clarkson. Good, and the assist goes to Russell.
You just got caught lying, him.
Fighting his way inside, Clarkson shows good body control.
Perez passes to Young. And that
one. Yeah.
12 in the game.
Great way to start to have easy layup against some soft feet.
Yeah, I think some of the players, Greg, quite honestly, are heavy leg. I mean, they don't seem to have been warmed up effectively here to start the second half.
Here's Clarkson. Fournier pulls it down.
If he can improve on what's been a shaky day for him thus far, they could stretch this lead.
And the foul.
2 points. With a chance for another one at the strike.
About the precision there of Prez.
Come on, that shot went in. Are you cheating me, game?
Third quarter of play was just over a minute and a half gone by.
That should not have went in. My free throw should have went in more than that.
And Young kicks to Prez. Back to Young, out left to the wing. Prez dishes to Young. Prez passes to Young, releases from 15.
And the foul.
Try to make it a 3-point play.
A nice start to the second half. Just one miss in their first 5 attempts.
For Orlando, they have had an off night from the
start. Yeah.
A look at their free throw statistics on the season, right around 74%.
You know, the numbers from the line, guys, are close to where they were last year. But just a tad worse, so not too bad.
But shot by you, no good. Imagine trail by three. And Young gets to Fournier. Young dishes to Vucevic. Oh, wide open look here for Ibaka.
Yeah.
Every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off. Prez in attack mode, just wanting to shoot the ball every time he's open.
Here's the screen. Here's the dish to eat. Mozgov gets the Clarkson. Off the run. Count it.
Ugh.
That one on Vucevic.
Damn it.
Angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish.
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. He made it look easy that time.
Here's Prez and foul calls.
Ooh.
It goes on Brandon Ingram. For the Lakers, hugely profitable, and they're always going to be willing to spend big.
Come on,
but with the taxes, it's harder to outspend other teams now.
And meanwhile,
the ball go in. What are you doing, game? You're just cheating, my guy. My guy should have way more points. This is fucking ridiculous. This is ridiculous. There's a three of those. I have not missed one free throw. You have cheated the line.
Back to Young. Just fine on the clock. It's deflected.
No, it was deflected. It was passed to my guy. My guy got the ball. You're lying and cheating. I didn't miss. If you're some fucking Harry Houdini, fucking Mr. Stretch Armstrong bullshit. Foul! Foul! bullshit! That is a defensive foul! That is any offensive foul! That guy was fucking... That was not offensive defense. You know, that was off. That was not offense. That was defense. You know it. Again, horrible call, ref. Are you cheating? As you teeing him.
And Fournier kicks to Prez. Pass to Vucevic. Young with no one around. Here's Ibaka, and it goes down.
Yeah. He's got seven. That's when you celebrate. Get a big basket to retake the lead.
Earlier in his career, before he started spending so much time on the perimeter. Russell, this is to Clarkson. And the pass to Mazda. He gets to Mazda. To the wing right side. The shot by Yee, no good. Randall's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Back to Ibaka. There's a good screen.
Oh. At least a foul.
12 points, and he's chalked up one three-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times, he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
The Magic last season had their best record in 4 years.
Because he teleported across the court! Yes, teleporting again. Yeah, he just allowed the fucking badly.
He's covered by Ben. And the call will be against Fournier.
Oh, bullshit. Flopping, that guy is fined?
Motion on offense. Nice assisting.
And when everyone's involved offensively...
It will be fined?
On the defensive side as well.
Clarkson passes to Mazda. He feeds it to Russell.
I got that ball. No, he didn't get that three because that shot was not taken because I hit the... I got the rebound. The only way I didn't if I was a ghost. Again with the ghosting bullshit.
It's gonna be fun to watch.
Yeah, I think it's a good fit for them guys. I mean,
you are ghosting my guy. That is illegal. My guy had no way he could not have gotten that rebound. Unless he's a fucking ghost. He's cheating. Game cheating.
To shoot. Mozgov gets to Dang. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Prez passes to Vucevic. And stolen by Russell.
Yeah, I think that was a foul. Or that was.
Checking out the numbers for Young. Just an incredible month of basketball. First in three-point field goal percentage. Second in scoring. And he's in the top 10 in field goal percentage. Really able to power his way to the bucket and finish through contact.
And not only is he dialing it up from deep, he's doing it with great consistency. One of our league's most efficient three-point shooters.
Biombo is checked in for the match. Peyton comes in for Evan Fournier. The Lakers also with a sub. Nancy's checked in for Mozgov. Just finds the shoot. Peyton outside. Goes up on the wing. Here's Biombo. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Take a look at the Magic. Earning the first place position with a terrific record. And we've seen them perform splendidly pretty much all season long so far. And they're definitely the team to beat. And check it out, Cleveland, 9 games back.
And right now for the Magic, they have caught the entire league off guard. This was not a position anyone thought they'd be in at this stage.
No, I could imagine that nobody would.
What they did and didn't do during the offseason. I mean, they had a vision, they set it out, and they stayed true to it.
Fires at the elbow. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Clarkson's got 9 points.
We've seen a noticeable improvement out of him since halftime. He didn't have a whole lot working in the first half.
Orlando moving the ball around. To the middle. Here's Biombo.
Yeah.
Mambo's got the game tied up here for the Magic. Lakers shooting a troubling 38% in the third. Not the finest work of this offense. Down low, and stolen by Biombo. 3-on-3. Fres dishes to Payton. Now here's Fres. He's tightly guarded. And Young kicks to Fres. Back to Young. Clock at 4. There's the pick for the lead, and it's a
left. Yeah.
And clever at running these pick and rolls. I mean, his IQ in these situations, exceptional.
Outside, Russell feeds it to Randall. Biombo with the block. And now, here comes Young leading the break. And Jeff Green, the bucket on the assist by Young. He's got 8. And let's get your guys' take now on the hustle steps for the Magic.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second-chance points they've been able to get.
And that one good from Clarkson.
And this is the advantage Clarkson has. I mean, he's a big combo guard and can convert through contact. And, you know, D'Angelo Russell, a one-and-done player out of my alma mater, the Ohio State University, came into the NBA at only 19 years old, and there were questions.
Yeah. LJ, baby.
And the coaching staff questioned his seriousness at times. I hope he can mature and grow into being a pro quickly because he's got tremendous talent.
He's got an advantage there off the
bench. Again, teleporting. Ghosting, bullshit.
More fight on the interior than they did on that court. They've got a battle inside.
This game has been a battle, and maybe they're starting to just...
Oh my god, I got fouled! That was a foul! There was no way that was not a foul. There was none.
Back to Russell.
Again, the teaming, man. My guy, again, ghosting. I'm ghosting. That went in. That was nice deep because that went in. She's cheating. Dying.
In the corner, it's Clarkson. 5 to shoot to the inside. Damn. Shot got him on the way up that time. Right here. Here's the franchise with the best winning percentage in NBA history, but that's in jeopardy this season.
Yeah, that's right. The Spurs are a close second, and if the Spurs finish with about 14 more wins than the Lakers this season, they'll claim that all-time spot.
And draw the foul, at
least. And it's Calderon in for Jordan Clarkson.
And they probably did pass him this year at that.
On the floor, who his teammates look up to.
And so he makes both from the line.
Hey, guys, Fred's playing well. He's got 10 rebounds and 7 assists. He's getting it done, making plays by setting up his teammates and grabbing some nice boards, too.
And also, how about the intangibles? All the little things that he's done, that's also really important.
Well, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where if he takes it, he makes it.
Payton gets to Biombo. Now, here's Fred. Tight defense on him. Payton dishes to Fres. Green, the screen. Fres passes to Young. Here's Fres.
Oh, fouled! Fouled a goaltending game. You can't do that shit. You cannot do that shit. That's illegal. It is illegal with too much contact.
For the lead. And Jang with the lay-in.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
Great half here. Exactly.
Again.
To the middle.
It's Magic ball. We're not the Laker. You're lying, game.
Group on the floor for Orlando. Big group substitution.
Lying game.
He's checked in for Randall. Tian Lien comes in for Lou Aldang. Jordan Clarkson, he's checked in for Jose Calderon. And D'Angelo Russell subbed in for Huertas. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Clarkson and Ingram fill out the wings. Tian Lien is out there with Mazda. And it's Russell in at the one spot. And Young kicks to Ibaka. Knocked away. Young dishes to Prez. And here's Lucevic, the feet to Prez. Good ball movement here by the Magic. To take the lead.
Yes! Yeah!
Young's got 11 in the second half. Lakers have gone 1-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. And oh, here we go. Young's got the fast break chance. Looking for Fournier. So he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Frenchman Fournier, always looking to get the shot up. Really good at drawing fouls. You know, you look at Evan Fournier, and he's very crafty. He said his favorite player growing up was Manu Ginobili, and I see some similarities in their games. Both are efficient scorers. They're able to make the three and slash and dash inside to finish around the rim.
Here's Ingram, and nothing is falling for him right now. The Magic leading by four. Young outside. Kicks it to Prez. Back to Young. Pass to Prez. Young with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. Here's Prez.
Bullshit. 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 Fouled. Fouled. Right on the hand right before the shot clock went off. That was a foul. You fouled my guy right on the hand. You didn't block it. You hit the guy on the hand. That is a foul. You hit the guy on the hand. That is a foul. Hit the guy on the hand, that is a foul. Sorry, that's not a shot clock violation, that was a foul. So it was. Should have hit the free throw line, that the ball the other way. You fouled the guy before the shot clock went off. Again, that's. Yeah.
And you know Prez will finish that play. And more importantly, Young knows that Prez will finish that nice score from Orange Juice.
Fournier against Clarkson. Osgarov a spin on Fournier. And this is to Ingram. Three-pointer is off the mark. Magic leading by six. Fournier in the corner. Young outside. Back to Fournier.
Yeah.
Fournier's got 6 points in the quarter.
Man, what a pass from Young. Really setting up the floor well for his teammates.
There's a screen to the inside. Here's Mozgov.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Definitely saved the layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
Mozgov hits them both.
Should have missed them both.
Base of $16 million. This team is a national phenomenon. They're one of the most popular teams in the country in any sport. Estimated to be the second most valuable franchise in the league after the New York Knicks.
Fournier with the ball. Tried to shoot. Ibaka, the pass to Young. Vucevic.
Nice rebound.
That gives him a double-double in this one. 11 points and 10 rebounds. Now, here's Clarkson. Here's Russell. And again, no good by the Lakers.
And they hold a huge advantage on the backboard.
Greg, and that's been the key to this lead.
Yeah.
You know what? That's what you like to see. A perfect pass leading you.
It worked out. Let's go now.
That's not work by them. were down by double digits at one point in the first quarter. Yeah, we're the ones up by 10. I should have been all along.
Listening in on what Luke Walton said to his team, he was begging them to step it up. He said, we've got to make the move now, or we're going to be out of time and out of luck. Give it everything you've got.
Good point. And the foul.
At times in his career, Ibaka has looked out of control when forced to finish through defenders. That time, keeps his poise and reaps the benefits.
We've really seen Ibaka doing his thing. He has 9 rebounds, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range.
No stretch to say the more points he gives them from beyond the arc, the better off they'll be.
And it's Prez, top of the key. To the paint. And it's Vucevic.
He got fouled.
Out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
It was easy when I was fouling him. The press is damn cold.
Boy, it's been a rough day for him, Kevin. I mean, he's not the only reason they're down right now, but he's certainly one of them. It's tipped.
He didn't get that ball. My guy did. You're lying and cheating.
Outside Russell. He has Ingram atop the key. Expanding his range. No good. Nice D from Fred. Young against Russell. Fred kicks to Young. And here is Fred. Back to Young. Fred dishes to Young.
And yes! It's a triple-double, baby.
To get that ball to Young outside when he caught it.
Russell against Young. Russell kicks to Mozgov. He dishes it to Clarkson. Pulls up on the elbow. Orlando grabs the miss. Here's Prez. He kicks to Vucevic. Ingram with the steal.
Oh, that was a bad call for pass. This is your teaming.
Passes to Clarkson. Mozgov dishes to Clarkson. It's deflected.
Nice job by Prez positioning himself for these blocks. I mean, sending a message with how he puts those shots in reverse.
And Ibaka.
Yeah.
He could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones.
Hey, they got a nice, comfortable lead here, fellas. Might as well keep it simple. Do it a plain, simple one-hander, just like pound cake. Crafty pass work there, getting it down low for the easy deuce.
Magic leading by 12. It's tipped. Prez with the ball. And
yeah.
Prez has got assist number 11.
All of a sudden, the 15-point lead.
Not bad.
Lakers take a timeout. Damn, the last two timeouts.
Hey, this is what happens when we play our brand of basketball. They cannot stop us.
No, they can't right at the moment.
Not enough space as a result for their athletes to really get inside and do what they can do. They've got to find a way to add shooting so they can stretch defenses a little more. And if that happens, then I think you'll see their offense take a big leap forward.
Plays it up and banks it in. And that's now 25 points for Brandon Ingram.
And not only can Ingram score from the perimeter, but he can also contribute inside. The way he releases his shot makes it very difficult to block.
Prez gets to Fournier. Now here's Prez. This now to Vucevic. Shot clock at 6. Shot's good from Young.
Yeah.
Now here on the second half. Well, this is what it's all about. Both Prez and Young have it going, and the numbers are piling up.
And Orr, she's putting the squeeze on for sure. A tremendous play from that duo.
In the corner, it's Ingram. Mazgov, this is to Russell. Here's Ingram. Off target from outside. Magic leading by 15. Here's Prez.
Come on, man. And
this is making it to the defense and easily earning the call. And guys, this is where their depth really comes into play. They've got such talent at that position.
They have fouled out.
Suffer much of a drop off.
One of two. Lakers in rebuild mode right now. As you look at this young core of players, guys, who do you think has the best chance of really becoming that foundational piece?
Well, Brandon Ingram is as complete a player as they come. I mean, the Lakers believe he can be a star. Julius Randle could be a double-double guy. One name that kind of flies under the radar is Jordan Clarkson. I mean, he's a mid-second round draft pick, but he's shown promise.
Well, you can be surprised if you can find guys and play around that could surprise you.
Outside, pass to Prez. The kick out to Young. Drills the three-point.
Yeah, that OJ, baby.
And that's just a little more for these fans to cheer about as they get ready to celebrate a W.
Well, let the party start. The celebration begins, and they're going to let their guys hear.
And Russell gets it to go.
Excellent size and feel for the game. D'Angelo really just scratching the surface of his potential.
And Young kicks to Prez. Back to Young.
Sports is sometimes it's the guys who can, or aren't always the guys who were picked to be stars that can surprise you. I mean, the guys who have been picked in the later rounds of drafts have come big stars, and
what a time to have this kind of,
you know, while the first round draft picks have been busts.
He gets every rebound that comes up.
Well, he practically has gotten everyone that's available. A 20 plus rebounding game is not something we get to see very often, Greg.
End up pulling away and winning this by 20. That is just a fourth quarter, they're down by three. Yeah. Right now, they scored 6 points in that quarter. We dominate. We just dominate that fourth quarter. I got only 3 points because it's 92-89. At one point, I don't know. Just like they're down by 30, it came back in. At least when I was on the court during that fourth quarter. They might have scored very many points in that quarter. I didn't look, but that was the way to look. I mean, that was just that was a brutal fourth quarter. If you're a Laker fan, I've seen that yesterday, or tweeted yesterday, but damn. I guess they had, Funko had the DuckTales. top series. Chance to win them. Like, ooh. About, I could think next month. Oops, that
Hey, yo!
There was no change, really. This, even though I didn't really change anything. I just said, I didn't mean to X that because I was trying to.
Hey, yo!
2,500. What the fuck? 2,500 for green and red ball? 50. Hey, it's just. I got the fucking price higher than they say on the thing. It's just bullcrap. Okay, yes I do. $5 left over. I know I had some left over from buying Life of Trains. I have enough to get that the ball. Yeah, stick out. Did we hit the green room? I thought we did.
diventato questo. Al resto non ci penso più, basta un attimo adesso. Al resto non ci penso più, non mi importa più. Di tutto ciò che è stato, non c'era la verità.
Drink any Red Bulls.
Hey, yo! It went back to the fucking boy in the boat. Even though it's that way, it's still selected. I switched back, I pushed B. And somehow, even though I bought the green rim, green net, it didn't fucking buy. Didn't, I had to buy a choice. Bell. I know I pushed stone. I know it should have been the card. There's no reason it wasn't. That was weird. It's weird overall. Okay, I'm gonna take a little break here, and we're gonna play a couple more games today, and back in just a few moments.
Stop now. I'm running.
And we're back. And they didn't change back to the green or red balls. Again. Alright, then. And Dark can't even go in. Steve actually has 2K of it. They got the. It's Christmas Eve. No, they don't deserve better. They're traitors. Schedules a team practice on Christmas Eve. On Christmas Day. What the fuck? Who schedules a team practice on Christmas Eve? Fuck you for scheduling that shit. Coach, you should be fired. Who schedules a team practice on a Christmas, a holiday? Bad, 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 bad. Bad. And we're exiting the stage right. Because it's a holiday. What am I gonna think? Everybody should not have to show up for fucking practice on a fucking holiday. On like, hello, Christmas. Hello, I mean, like it's snowing. Cried on the streets of San Francisco. I don't have an agenda. All I do is pretend to be okay. So my friends can't see my heart in the blender. And lately, I've been killing on my time. Reading through your messages, my favorite way to lie. Take my head and let it spin. Make some bread for all my sins. Say a word, do it soon. Right, the cleanup's over me. Damn, I missed the DuckTales premiere. It's on demand, but... I'm just trying to you say, do I own a watch? Do I know what time it is? Just take care of something real quickly. It's after 2 a.m. and that's asking a lot of you right now. All she talking about is come and see me for us. Come and see me for us. You don't ever come to me. You don't ever come to me. All she ever says, come and see me for us. Come and see me for us. You'll never come to me. You'll never come to me. I've been up for 2 whole days thinking what I did to keep you going. Thumbing through the voicemails that you left me telling me where I went wrong. Hey, cool. Eric Green's F. Change people, change feelings, change too. Never thought the circumstances would have changed you. You said you never traded, no. Hey, you said that. You said that. And I believed you when they told me don't. Yeah, that's you, man. That's you, man. But either way, you're still invited. In I shot a bunch of times. Probably one time, one full time, I'm recording. Don't have permits, but the serious premiere is not even like a preview, it's not even like the full premiere. It's the season premiere is like in like next month. Serious premiere, actually full premiere and reboot next month. I think it's something like it. Don't quote me on that. I thought it was actually full premiere. Didn't even know this. You're running. Thanks. Thanks, man. I had the feeling that I still was able to make the Adidas, right? Because the practice hadn't ran yet right before the meet. So, you know, we're freaking all in Christmas. Play the game! That's what's Grizzlies. Hey guy, where it's in nobody cares a bit. Pre-game show, sponsored by right. Welcome. Johnson here with my colleagues, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith.
And tonight, it'll be the Memphis Grizzlies going up against the Magic in Orlando. Checking out the Magic, they have been a team on a mission this season. Best record in the NBA. We're getting deep into the schedule now, and they continue playing dominant basketball. And guys, Zach Randolph in this game tonight, he's always been the first guy that comes to mind when you think about those blue-collar guys who grind it out underneath. In this kind of style of play, is it still viable in the NBA?
Well, you know, he's one of those rare power forwards that, you know, still plays inside and posts up, scores. You know what, Ernie?
What?
He might be extinct. He's one of the last of the dying breed of post-up big guys.
Most modern power forwards have developed a little more range, but it's still possible to dominate while playing only in the paint. I know I did it a long time ago. I don't want to talk about myself. We're talking about Zach Randolph right now.
And that'll do it for us here. Again, thank you for not talking about yourself anymore.
Yeah. Where I like actually make us force to watch this stuff fully.
Where we are broadcasting our action live today. This is Kevin Harlan joined by Greg Anthony.
Like now,
David Aldridge. For the Grizzlies, their last game, a win against the Houston Rockets.
And they tailored a fantastic, I thought, offensive game plan. And that went, I mean, they knew exactly how to exploit the holes in that defense.
And that comes from playing your opponent, knowing how they operate, and exploiting any mismatches that become available.
And before we get going, let's catch up with David Aldridge, who had a chance to talk with head coach Frank Vogel. David, what do you have to say?
Well, Kevin, he said defensively their main priority is going to be preventing points in the paint. He told me we can't let them get comfortable inside. That's what'll hurt us. He wants them playing a very physical brand of D down low. We'll see if they got the message. Kevin?
Thank you, David. And tonight, Steve, two top-tier teams going head-to-head. A lot of excitement around this one.
You want to see the best in the business go at it. Then you get a chance to measure yourself if you're one of those teams. And I think other guys watching it on other teams, you get a chance to see great basketball.
And think of the viewership for this team, too, on 2K.
Yeah.
Huge.
What was that again?
Huge.
And the starting group for the Grizzlies. Conley and Allen working once again together in the backcourt. Down low, the tough pair of Zebo and Gasol.
Yeah.
The small forward.
Hey, really hard not to respect Prez. His work ethic is what allows him to drain these shots, even with contact.
Now here's Allen. Good-looking screen by Gasol. Nobody near Parsons. Oh, good with the triple. Young against Conley. And Young kicks to Prez.
Oh, come on. That turn went in.
Last time they met was in Memphis.
Yeah, and looking back at their last game against this club, they were badly out-rebounded. You love how Parsons was able to react to the defense and pulled up with the...
Come on, let the ball go in! What the fuck are you doing?
Fournier against Allen. Conley dishes to Allen.
Angle turning back in that bullet.
There's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. Zach Randolph, one of the toughest, most physical players in the league, and Steve, he's an emotional leader as well on this team.
Well, his approach to the game, he plays with a lot of heart, he's confident, he's aggressive, and he's a hard worker. He doesn't back down from the challenge, and he's willing to shoulder the load when he has to.
And the first one at the line is good. And in his heyday, Zach Randolph averaged 20 points and 12 rebounds. And Steve is getting up there in age, but still a player to reckon with.
Yeah, it's funny. His nickname, we call him first name 20, last name 10. That's for double doubles. And he's one of those players that great position rebounder, can score down on the block, gives you an effort on the defensive end. But what he does is give you a guy that you can throw the ball in, settle your offense, and he can get a bucket.
Shot clock at three. Offensive rebound. Here's Vucevic. Back to Fournier. There's the feed to Ibaka. And Young kicks to Ibaka. Young passes to Prince.
What the fuck? Oh, come on, game. That was just bullshit.
It's rebounded by Prince.
That was bullshit, game.
Was going to fall.
The kick out to Young.
Wide open. Oh, come on! Let the ball go in, you worry. I don't care. It's cheating that went in. They went my fucking shots early. So we should be up. This should have been 5. 2 shots that you fucking knocked out. That's no 4. So we have by 4.
Now here's Allen. 8 points his last outing. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Prez dishes to Young. Prez kicks to Young. Another miss.
Stop knocking the ball out of the basket. That is illegal, game.
He's averaging a bit over 5 points.
It should have been in.
And it comes off the front of the rim.
And they're 1 of 5 to start this game. Just really haven't gotten into a flow offensively.
And here's Young from the arc.
Thank you, but we should be up. He's taking 10 points from us, so he's up by 10. So it's 15 to 5 right now. Cheating game.
To the paint, it's stolen by Vucevic. And Young kicks to Prez.
Let the ball go in the basket! That was a bad shot selection! That was a good layup! That was fucking knocked out of the basket!
Allen with
by you, AI, and that is illegal!
No buckets yet in the game for him. Out to the right wing. Just 5 to shoot. Conley, the pass to Gasol. 18 that time from Vucevic. Orlando's gone, just 1 of 4 from 3-point range here in the first. Young for 3. Another shot. Rejected by
Ugh. Foul.
Always on the lookout to reject the shot.
Here's Conley. 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Mike Conley Jr., I love him. He's one of those guys, very steady, very heady, does the right thing as far as running a team, being able to distribute the basketball, and can score when needed.
And Conley loves to attack off the pick and roll at 6'1". Steve Conley isn't really an above-the-rim finisher.
No, he's not, but he can score at 3 levels, behind the 3.
And the foul.
To the mid-lane jumper.
And as you hit the midway point of the season,
oh, come on! AI, you were being caught cheating.
When you're just out of it at the midway point, then there's some teams, you know, they're looking to make a big trade that can boost them and catapult them 2 or 3 seats higher. So it's depending on where your team is. I just don't want to be on that team where by February you're out of the playoffs.
That's a death march, isn't
yes.
it?
And folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backcourt.
Prez dishes to Ibaka. And up top. From deep. That one's good. Maybe that'll get him going after a 2-for-6 start.
What a tremendous stroke on the 3 ball. Young's range is lethal.
And all the screen. They set the screen. Gasol gets to Conley. Parsons, right side. Not enough on that one as it misses.
It has not been an easy quarter for him offensively, but I like that he's staying aggressive.
Vucevic with the bucket.
Yeah, nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
Inside. And there's Parsons on the...
That was a defensive breakdown. I fucking blocked the shot. Again, ghosting game. Ghosting. There they go. They were fucking... cheating. It's same with the fucking AI goaltending. You're being caught over and over again, alright, in this game doing it. It's cheating.
You're supposed to let the ball go in the basket if the fucking ball is supposed to go in the basket. You're not. You're cheating.
From the old point guards back in the day.
And he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
I have to admire how steady Prez is on these shots, sensing the contact coming.
Oh my god, stop knocking the third shot of the basket. I've hit both free throws. You're lying.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Shot's good by Ibaka.
He really fought on the glass there and did a tremendous job coming up with that rebound.
And here is Conley. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Houston.
And he also looked to attack at the defensive end of the floor. Three steals in that game.
Yes, that goes in.
Again, it was not a defensive breakdown if I was right there for pressure on him.
For his guys.
Now here's Prez. Covered by Parsons.
Cat went in. Again, lying and feeding game.
To go harder. Soft lay-in won't cut it.
And Chandler Parsons hits from deep. Parsons got it all.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
Orlando's gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from 3-point range so far.
My set game in Miami. And you cheated me over and over again.
There's Prez. He's got 6. Young with no one around.
Yeah. UJ, baby.
Awareness there. Prez whipping the ball all over quickly to the uncovered man.
Green with a screen on Young. Right side, Gasol. Shoots from the elbow. It's rebounded by Prez. Prez has got his 3rd rebound tonight. Young outside. Pass to Prez. Back to Young. He dishes it to Prez. Now the pass to Vucevic. Yes, that goes in.
I didn't pass it. I shot it. Why did it pass? I pushed the ball in the pass. What the fuck?
Very impressive.
Here's Parsons. It's deflected. Now, here is Young. Against the Lakers, he was really on his game.
It's yeah.
Shooting at a 4 of 9 clip.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Conley against Young. Conley the pass to Green. Puts it out to Parsons. Sinks the 3-pointer. Parsons got it.
He was in game. Two problems with that. I don't think he should hit that. B, he was inside the line. We shot it.
Prez gets to Vucevic. Feeds it to Fournier. To the inside. Just 5 to shoot. On its way from Young for 2. And again, it's Orlando converting.
Can you believe this? The defense has no answers. He's been unconscious this quarter.
Outside Conley. Gasol, a screen on Young. Green, the screen. Conley kicks to Green. Gasol dishes to Parsons. Left block shot on the way. Parsons can't get that one to fall. Magic leading by 6. Young passes to Prez. Ibaka, wide open, he fires.
Ugh.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
And it's out of bounds. The Grizzlies able to retain possession here.
You know what? I love it.
Oh, my dad get the rest. I've played good time in it. Almost.
There with Young. And there's and it's Ibaka in at the power forward. This is out there for Orlando. Gasol. Here's Parsons. Lots of contact there.
Except he didn't get the rebound. I did. I have to be a ghost not to have gotten that rebound.
A very versatile player.
Not one of the biggest free agency moves of the past offseason, but had high impact with Chandler Parsons coming over to the Grizzlies. And, you know, Gia, you look at his skill set, and he fits right in with what Memphis is trying to do.
Yeah, I think overall, Memphis had a great offseason, you know, acquiring Parsons and retaining Conley. Memphis hadn't had a lot of luck luring big free agents in the past, and Parsons is perhaps one of their biggest gets as a franchise. And for Parsons, he gets a good deal for himself and continues to play for a team that has always been competitive.
Interesting fact is that this
thank you, Kevin.
The Memphis used to be in the Vancouver Grizzlies.
What was quite a display for him. Nobody took over the game.
What? Bullshit. Flop. If I gotta go for a foul, there's a flip.
That one for the rest of his life.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Allen's checked in.
Yeah, and I let the flap anyway.
For the three. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Parsons. Get this break in the action. Let's find out which rookies have been lining it up from downtown this month. Justice Young, number one.
You know, coming into the NBA, you knew he could stroke it from long range. And over the past month, he's just shown us exactly that.
Here's Prez. And
yeah.
And now a 9-point magic lead.
And Prez scores from anywhere, inside, outside. This guy does it all.
Allen kicks to Daniels. Handoff, pitches to Allen. He gets that one.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
He also understands better than most how to use angles, and that was the reason why.
Tony Allen, and I know best, calling one of his games, he motioned over to us at the table, letting us know he was first team all defense, one of the best perimeter defenders we have in this league.
Now here's Prez. 20 points for him last game against the Lakers. Young pass to Prez. And they forced the shot.
Oh, fuck you. There was still time left. Again, teaming.
The shots have been divided up between 3-point shots and 2-point shots for Memphis. Daniels. Gasol, a screen on Young. They set the pick. Daniels kicks to Randall. A jump hook. That one a little long.
And a foul. Did draw the foul.
Play defense, but Tony Allen, like you said, he wants to get right in your airspace. He forces a lot of turnovers, and he's never shy about making some contact. He was voted the toughest player in the league by a survey of the GMs.
Well, teams like the Spurs love to generate catch and shoot jumpers, but it's awfully tough to defend a guy who can pull up off the dribble at any time. And Steve, I'm sure you like guys that can do that pull-up jump shooting with a lot of regularity. Any names come to mind, guys that stick out in that category?
Yeah, Stephen Curry. Yeah. I mean, Chris Paul, Kyrie Irving, Dwayne Wade, more of a mid-range jump shot, Sean Livingston, more in the mid-range. So you have a lot of guys, a variety of guys that can do that. Paul George, I like the way he can pull up the jump shots at his size.
Some guys like that station, catch it and shoot. Some guys want to think about it a little bit, will move a little bit. And there are those other ones which run, put on the brakes, and fire away.
I was never one of those guys. I didn't have good brakes.
You know, your brakes. You're not evidence brakes, did you?
No, not
you
at all.
My brakes are
out. Oh, fuck you!
And the rejection by Ibaka.
That's it by my guy.
Ibaka just has that rare instinct for it.
The Grizzlies have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
Been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group, only around 75%.
And the back I got grabbed from my block is ridiculous.
In league history. You think of the Showtime Lakers, the bad.
I gave the basket. Again, you're lying and cheating game.
Tony Allen coined the phrase way back in 2011. It comes to define this team's brand and its style of play. Toughness and heart. They had that lunch pail mentality.
Here's Prez, following the basket by Mark Gasol. And Young kicks to Ibaka, and Ibaka slams it in.
Yeah, and just superb work there by Young. So unselfish with the basketball. Really likes getting the ball to his teammates.
Looking screened by Gasol. Allen gets to Parsons. There's a screen down low. And if he can count it, he'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Didn't make the basket.
Really the catalyst for the Memphis Grizzlies. He's a defensive
again, you're knocking the ball in or it was going out. It's teaming game. You and it did it. If the ball's not supposed to go in, it's not supposed to not get in. If that's supposed to not go in, it's not supposed to not get in. Well, same way. Oh my god, stop the teaming! Again!
Here's Allen. Orlando grabs the miss. Bucket's got his third rebound on the night. Prez dishes to Vucevic out to the right wing. Magic moving the ball around. Kicks it to Prez. Back to Young. Pass to Prez. Just four to shoot. Count that one.
Yeah.
Justice Young.
And not a surprise that Young is paving the way on offense. He does this all the time for his team.
They grab their own miss.
He was red hot in the first quarter. Hit three threes. Now suddenly struggling to find the range.
Elio J, baby!
And Prez knew what Young was thinking. And boy, was the setup perfect.
Daniels with it. And off a screen on Young. And here's Daniels. And it's Parsons, stop the key. Looks a big height bouncing coach.
Again, back in that pole, and it's illegal.
And even with a hand in his face, Chandler is in total control.
Now the dish to Young. He gets it to Vucevic. Now here's Prez. Goodbye, Parsons. Screened by Ibaka. Here's Prez.
Yeah.
He won't miss many of those.
And you can just see him psyching himself up after a play like that. Nice slam by Prez.
Gasol a screen. Daniels gets to Gasol. Fades away. Prez with the rebound. Prez has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Young in the corner. Pass to Prez. He tries for 3. Again, Young misses. By 8. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Baca against Randall. Dishes it to Daniels. Gasol a screen. Memphis needs to get off a shot here. Snatched up.
And with the defense disrespect.
A double-double.
From 13.
Yes. Yeah.
And now it's a 10-point Magic lead. Memphis has gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter.
Love the energy, fellas. I really do. And now we gotta keep it up and stay focused. Remember, you're my Pippen.
A lot of people point to
the. A lot of pressure to put on two rookies, and then they have to call it Pippen and Jordan.
Already at halftime. What's been the key to get you going?
I've just been trying to play true to myself, man.
too often I find myself playing with restraint, you know, trying to let everyone else get a chance to shine. I'm better off when I just go out there and lay it all on the line and act like I'm the only one out there. Numbers show that when I'm at my best, you know?
I'm glad you're coming on with this show.
All right, gentlemen, hustle up. That was a great first half.
I like it. And the third quarter about ready to get underway. We're seeing a tremendous game from Fred.
He's just been terrific. This is what they needed from him. He's played like a man possessed right now, and his team is thriving as a result.
Tipping off the second half, here's David Fizdale's five. Down low, the tough pair of Zebo and Gasol. Conley and Allen working once again together in the backcourt. And it's Parsons in at the three spot. Prez kicks to Young. He feeds it to Prez. And out of bounds is Memphis.
Oh my god, that is on fucking Young. That is not on me. Don't call it a turnover on me. If the guy fucking decided to not even catch the ball, it was passed right through his hands. Can't do nothing about that shit.
And this one, fellas, I mean, both of these teams play at a breakneck pace.
Allen kicks to Randall. It's stolen by Ibaka. Young passes to Vucevic. Well, shot that time, not on target.
Again, ghosting.
And about a minute of action so far in the third quarter. Here's Allen. Gasol a screen. Six to shoot. Conley against Young. Conley's shot is off. Magic leading by eight. And Fournier kicks to Prez.
Yeah.
Prez is feeling it. Your best bet is to keep feeding him the rock. A natural scorer who knows how to create for himself.
And for Memphis, they're shooting a low 30% mark from the field. Now here's Conley. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14.5 points a game. Gasol dishes to Conley. Another miss by Conley.
And that makes it 0 for 3 coming out of the half. Not what they wanted or were expecting.
And Young kicks to Prez.
Yeah.
Back to Young. In.
Yeah, OJ, baby.
Nice jump shot by Young. Looking totally in the zone, draining these J's.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, the Grizzlies are starting to show their age a little bit. Last season was an example of that. But they
yeah,
style of play, that's hard to gauge. Mark Gasol said, the game is evolving, and we as players and as a team have to evolve. We have to change things and adjust. We need tweaks and counters from game to game and year to year.
Bull crap.
They know they needed more shooting. Allen kicks to Randall. 18 feet away, and he knocks it down. Randolph's got five now.
And Randolph's skill in knocking down the mid-range jump shot is important to this team. Helps to have a big man with a jumper.
And Vucevic kicks to Prez. The kick out to Young. And it's Prez, top of the key. Back to Young. Magic moving the ball around. Ibaka, no luck. The Grizzlies trail by seven. Allen passes to come. Young against Gasol. The jump hook bounces high off.
Again with the teaming. You're knocking balls in and knocking balls out game. It is easy to Gabriel.
That's his first foul.
You know what? Tried to step in and cut him off, but just didn't get there quick enough.
That bucket in no time.
Yeah.
Overall, hitting a high percentage of them. That's what has this team rolling.
Now Allen. Conley left side. time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And back in 2013, Mark Gasol winning Defensive Player of the Year. Steve, one of the more controversial award winners, but he is a very valuable defender, as we all know.
Yeah, the reason why you look for guys to win this award, that they get a lot of steals, they block shots, they're very athletic. Well, Mark Gasol is just a smart defender. Now, he's going to block a lot of shots, but he's going to be in the right place at the right time.
Come on, let the ball go in the basket. You're knocking balls out of the basket. It's against the NBA rules. Okay. Is. Well, Mickey Rubino is supposed to be defending. Everyone will be able to fucking find him.
And the Magic making a change here. Augustine's checked in. Augustine against Allen. Shot clock at 6. Inside, Parsons.
Oh, bullshit. Again, with the cheating.
Desperately, and boy, did they come up big. And this comeback was fueled by doing it on both ends of the floor. Let's see if they have that same energy level to keep this up.
Yeah.
Young's got 19 points.
Yeah, sensational focus. Young not letting the D affect his jumper at all. What a gifted shooter.
Allen passes to Daniels. The feed to Parsons. Launches a 3, and Vucevic pulls it down. Vucevic has got rebound number 8 now on the night.
Come on, let the that was a bad shot selection. That was a good one, and went in. You were lying. I hate when you do that shit. Oh, okay. Bad shot selection. Even though it was a good one, it should have went in. Again, lying.
It's a 3. No good. Orlando's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Let's it go from 11.
Let the ball go in the basket. My shot went in, not the other guys. The guy didn't have to shoot because I went in. Oh, fucking hitting my guy.
So much time on the perimeter.
In the corner, Parsons with it.
No.
Taking a look here at the numbers for Young. Over the last month, he has been spectacular, averaging 29 points per game, 5 assists, and 2 rebounds. What incredible numbers. He has been a beast.
Steve, I still remember when you went to Atlanta and that trade from Miami. Pretty much everyone agreed it was a heist. It was a steal for the Hawks. Do you think we see less lopsided trades these days?
Yeah, we do, Kevin. Reason why, because of the salary cap. You're trying to match money and money together. And I think right now, Kevin, you're starting to see, because of the contract situations, you want value for value. So they're not as lopsided as they used to be.
He gets that one.
Yeah.
They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Allen against Augustine. Randall. And another miss by Memphis.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
The kick out to Young. Kick by Vucevic. Here's Prez, 4 on the clock.
Come on, let the ball go in the basket. We're not getting the ball at the 15.
And the shot no good, a bit short.
And if the shot's not there, you've got to understand that. Move the basketball. Those types of shots are low quality. You're not going to win too many friends on that one.
On the outside. Augustine from outside drops in the tray.
Yeah.
Take a seat.
Hey, this is what happens when we play our brand of basketball.
Up by 12.
Just keep squeezing that orange juice, gentlemen.
More ball movement.
Here's Allen.
It's not time to take me out yet.
Fourth quarter action. All fueled up and ready to go. And so in the game for the Magic, Ibaka is the forward, Vucevic in the middle. Young is up there with Evan Fournier, and it's Prez in at the small forward position. Young in the corner. Shoots from the block.
Come on, a foul. Beat it, showing in. Again, that's cheating game. If they let the ball go in the basket, what you're doing is air goaltending, and it's illegal. No, mine went in, he didn't.
Fourth quarter here for the Grizzlies. Prez gets to Young. Magic moving the ball around. The pass to Vucevic. Young dishes to Prez. To the middle here.
And the foul.
It looked like on the foul, and he's called for the flagrant.
And Kevin, that's a dangerous play right there. I mean, I don't like to see a player put an opponent in harm's way as much as you just saw him do that.
And a flagrant, too, so.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. The officials were all over it. They weren't going to let him off the hook that time. Prez passes to Fournier to the paint. Here's Prez.
Did draw the foul, at least.
So skilled at drawing these type of fouls.
And that one missed.
Ball on the basket! You're being caught, cheating game.
Lead assistant for a while. His name has been floating around in the coaching ranks for a long time. Happy to see him get that job.
Conley with it. Picked by Randolph. Allen outside. He dishes it to Parsons. Sinks that one from the post. Parsons got 5 points now in the quarter. And with Fizdale, a bright young coach, you're getting a coach who has been a part of multiple championships in Miami. That is why the Grizzlies went out and sought his leadership.
That was a bot. That selection as good. And it was fouled.
He is a coach that relates very well with players.
What the fuck? Am I a ghost? No. Then I got it. It wasn't tipped in. It was put to my hand. Got that ball. That was a foul. 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 Daddy shot back. There was a foul. That was all hand. All hand. No, it was not a defensive breakdown. It was cheating. It was stopped. It was not get to the basket. You were there. Again, cheating. You're ghosting. Again, ghosting game. You have to play right. You just fucking big guys go through it like I'm not there.
That doesn't sound very good, does it, partner? But they said the injury was in the best possible spot.
Stop knocking my ball out of the basket! Stop knocking your ball into the basket! That is illegal!
It's really good to see this young man.
That is cheating game! It is cheating.
For this team.
Feeds it to Vucevic. Kicks to Fournier. Here's Prez.
Oh my god, I got fouled again! You're not calling it! Call the fucking foul! Call the fucking foul! You have to call the fucking foul! There's not a turnover when you were oh my god! Stop ghosting! Stop ghosting! Stop fucking ghosting! Stop fucking this magically having guys be there. It shouldn't be there. Stop. Stop air goaltending. Stop not getting shots. They're fucking knocking shots out. They're supposed to be going in. Stop knocking my shots out. Stop knocking shots in. They're not supposed to be going in. Stop fucking cheating.
Draws the foul on the shot. A trick to the line to shoot two.
Parsons can be very tricky when he goes at a defender. Knows how to draw fouls.
And he knocks down the first one.
Except there was no foul.
He's perfect.
Either of those should have went in. Again, AI goaltending stows up. It is goaltending if you're not getting the ball in the basket while it's on the rim, and you did that, AI. That is goaltending.
strong finish under heavy pressure all over. Perez has got 21.
And I tell you what, if he's going to be a factor here down the stretch, he is going to have to make some shots. Just 1 of 5 here in the quarter.
Picked by Randall.
Because you've been cheating me. You've been knocking my shots out of the basket.
That one goes in.
It's illegal. It's go tanning.
He still nails it.
Fournier, this is DeYoung. Perez passes to Ibaka. They get the rebound. Fournier, nice work on the board. Staying off with the basket. And the Magic lead by 7.
And they continue to control the glass.
Outside Conley. He kicks to Randolph. That's in there. Conley with the assist.
Defensive breakdown. That wasn't my guy. How did I get points for taking away from that? On that one on me. That was on me. That was on me.
Ibaka kicks to Fournier. To the inside. Followed hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. It goes on Chandler Parsons.
And how about the skill from Perez down on the block, working hard inside and getting the contact in the process.
That free throw good from Perez. He's off on the second.
I did not miss a second, you liar.
For him, but he's still trying to keep a positive mindset.
Conley, and the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Conley.
Again, the flying and cheating room.
Leading by 6. Perez dishes to Fournier.